Shalom, Christopher Enoch here. Now, you know, a lot of Christians believe that God's law, and I'm talking about more than just the Ten Commandments here, we're talking about the laws of God that are in the five books of Moses, are impossible to obey. You know, I've heard Christians say, you know, there are like 613 laws that God has, and these are the laws of perfection, and nobody can obey them. The purpose of the law is just to prove that man is a sinner. Mankind they're all sinful. And the only Jesus obeyed all those laws. There's nobody else that obeyed all those laws. There's nobody else that can obey those laws. Jesus is the only one that actually obeyed all the laws of God and fulfilled it and obeyed it for us so that he could impute that righteousness to us. The problem with that belief is that it is absolutely wrong according to the scriptures, okay? I know a lot of you might be going, oh, what are you talking about? This is what I've heard all my life, or this is what I've been taught in Bible school, or this is what I've been taught in church. But listen, it says that, you know, there are many different people in the Bible that are called righteous, you know, righteous by obeying God's law. We got Noah, for example. We got Job that was declared blameless, okay, according to the law of God. He was blameless. In Luke chapter 1, verse 6, we got Zechariah and Elizabeth, the parents of John the Baptist, and it says they were blameless, and it says they obeyed all the commands of the Lord, okay? They obeyed all the commands of the Lord. We've got even the Apostle Paul himself saying in Philippians that according to the law, according to the Torah, according to the law of God, he is blameless, okay? There's not one thing you can point at him and say, oh, there you messed up. There you are. You're sinning in this area. He said he is blameless. So this whole thing that, you know, that man, or that, you know, that no one can obey God's law at all, that it only points to Jesus, and the only purpose of God's law is to point to Jesus because no one can obey it, only Jesus can obey it. That sounds all fine and dandy. That sounds so Christian-like. That sounds so true. The problem is, it is a lie, and it is a lie that can lead you astray and deceive you and make you lawless, okay? Like, if Satan wants anything from you, it would be to be lawless, not to obey God's law. You know, he wants you to disobey God's law, and one of the ways he can get you to disobey God's law is to totally give up on it altogether. It is an error. Now, not only does it say that there are several people in the Bible, and I mean, that those are several direct, you know, it says very explicitly these people are blameless or perfect in God's sight, okay? Not only that, okay, but it also says, okay, the law of God or the Torah is Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, okay? Genesis, Exodus, Numbers, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, okay, the five books of Moses. So we got the five books of Moses, which is called the Torah or the law, the guidelines and instructions that God gave us. Now, God gave us all of these instructions, all of these guidelines, all of these rules, okay? Some people say it's 613. I can't confirm that myself. I didn't count every single one of them. It could very well be 613. But I need to make it very clear, and this is something that a lot of people don't realize either, that all of the laws, all 613, don't apply to everyone. Okay. For example, there are 100 to 130 laws alone that deal with only the sacrificial system in the temple. Okay. So, I mean, nobody can obey all of 613 laws. Even Jesus himself could not obey it because he wasn't a priest that would go in the temple himself. I mean, in the days of in Bible days, he couldn't just go in and offer all these different kinds of offerings, as it says explicitly in, you know, for example, Leviticus. Okay, he couldn't obey that because there are laws only for women. There are laws only for men. There are laws only for priests. There are laws for, like, different laws for different people, different laws for different things, different times, okay? So don't think that you have to, or anybody has to, obey all 613 laws. You know, it's just, that's just ridiculous, because not all laws apply to everyone. But this is a point that's the kicker. This is the kicker. This is the straw that breaks the camel's back, so to speak. In Deuteronomy chapter 30, okay, after all the laws have been brought down by Moses, after the law of God has been given, okay, and written down, it says in Deuteronomy chapter 30, God says, all of these laws, he says, don't think they are too hard for you. They are not hard for you. They are not hidden from you, it says in some translations, that these commandments are not hidden from you. In other words, they are not too hard for you to do. It's not like you have to go, you know, you have to do all kinds of things to search them out and to find them and to obey them. They are easy to obey. The word hidden in Deuteronomy chapter 30, when God says, these commands that I just gave you, all of these commands, all of these regulations, all of these rules are not hidden from you. It means they are not too hard for you. Some of the translations actually says they are not too hard for you. It means too hard. He says you don't have to climb up, you don't have to go up into heaven to get them. You don't have to dig down into the depths of the earth to get them. You don't have to do any mighty feats, you know, climb Mount Everest or something like that. They're right there. The laws of God are right there in your mouth and in your heart. And this is what Paul was saying in Romans chapter 10, where it says the word of faith is the word that we preach, the word that is in your mouth and in your heart. He was quoting from Deuteronomy chapter 30. God said very specifically, these commandments are not too hard for you. They are easy for you to obey, okay? Don't let anybody tell you that God's law is impossible to obey. God is not a tyrant. He does not bark out commands to people that he knows cannot obey them, okay? That is a tyrant. That is abuse. God is not like that. God the Father is not like that. If you want to know what God the Father is like, look at Jesus. If you want to know what Jesus is like, look at God the Father. Remember, it says in Malachi chapter 3, I am the Lord. I am Yod-Heh-Wah-Heh. I am the Lord. I change not. He promised his people. He comforted his people. In Malachi, I change not. He did not lie. He didn't make a mistake. He never changes from Genesis to Revelation. He gives us commands that are easy to obey. That's why John said, you know, that his commandments are not burdensome. They're not burdensome. They are not hard to obey. Now, some of you know, I know that you're bound to certain kinds of sin. You're bound to pornography. You're bound to masturbation. You're bound to gluttony or whatever else like that. Those sins, that bondage, that slavery that you're under can be broken by the power of God. God is not weak that he cannot break that power of sin over your life. And that is what the crucifixion was all about. So remember, God's law is actually easy to obey. That's what God said. He's not a liar. Anybody who says that God's law is impossible to obey because, you know, it was only for Jesus to obey and yada, yada, yada. Oh, it makes it look all pretty and Christian-like and everything. The problem is it's a lie. The problem is those people who say that are actually accusing God of lying, because God said it's not hard to obey. It's not hard. Deuteronomy chapter 30. So remember, obey God. It's not hard, okay? It is what God wants from you. And sinlessness is not perfection in God's, in man's sight, okay? Several days ago, I had an argument with somebody on the internet that said, we're talking about a certain preacher, and this guy said, well, this preacher thinks he's sinless. I said, well, First off, you actually spelt sinless wrong, okay? You made a spelling mistake. So you're not perfect, okay? But that is not a sin. A lot of people don't understand what sin is. They don't understand what it really means to sin. To sin in God's sight is different than sinning in man's sight. To be perfect in God's sight is different than being perfect in men's sight, okay? God gives you commands, and they're not hard to obey. Man, on the other hand, man, well, my goodness, if you make a spelling mistake, or if you, you know, fall, trip walking down the sidewalk, or if you forget something that you were taught as a child, yeah, you'll be accused of being imperfect. But that's not being imperfect in God's sight. There's no laws saying, thou shalt not make a spelling mistake, okay? Thou shalt not mispronounce this word. There's no laws about that, okay? So perfection in man's sight is a whole lot different than perfection in God's sight. So don't confuse the two, but that's another video. So keep on keeping on, obey God, read the scriptures, and do it, you know, do the best to your ability. I know that all 613 laws don't apply, like I said, but God expects us to obey the laws that we can obey. There are lots of laws that we can obey, and do it for your sake. Do it for the sake of those around you. Thanks for watching.